distinguished guests and all the media friends. Welcome to the Greater China Alternative Investment and Alternative Data Conference. I'm Zhang Yuan with Yicai, Shanghai Media Group. Today we're going to focus on the alternative data. Why is that? Because with the development of artificial intelligence and big data technologies, the alternative data has surpassed the traditional financial data, drawing much, much more attention from the global financial giants, and also very widely used by them. And its importance is growing gradually, and consequently, alternative data and alternative investment have become a very important and hot topic in Wall Street, even in the international financial area. In this year's event, it's jointly sponsored by the Beryl Consulting Group and Central University Finance and Economics and GTCOM and ZhongJinPuHui, and also with the support of S&P Global. Every year on today, July the 30th, GTCOM holds the mid-year ceremony. Why today? Because today is not only a milestone of GTCOM, is not only the birth of GTCOM, but also the day when GTCOM released its latest AI big data research results. Since the year 2013 until now, it's over 6 years. And in this year event, unlike the past, it's more significant. A week ago, GTCOM and Shenzhen Securities Information Company Limited, a subsidiary of Shenzhen Stock Exchange, jointly launched the GTCOM Hong Kong Stock Index 100. Now, GTCOM has already become a global leading fintech and research data analytical company, and this year, GTCOM's participation in this event also proves the action that GTCOM is consolidating its presence in alternative data, financial quantification, and fintech. It is committed to working with other peers in the international financial sector to explore the path to global fintech development and fulfill its ambition and vision in alternative financial investment. At the meantime, today's event, it also has another very important major identity. It's the first Beryl Elite Forum held in the Chinese mainland by Beryl Consulting Group, a very well-known alternative investment company from the United States. The forum has been held in New York for two consecutive sessions, attracting more than 500 finance and technology companies and investment institutions, including S&P, Bloomberg, Thomson Reuters, Morgan Stanley, Citibank, and also Bridgewater Associates. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's go straight to our main topic today. First of all, let's welcome Mr. Lu Shijie, the chairman of the ZhongJinPuHui and chairman of CUFE Culture and Finance Research Center, to deliver a speech. Welcome.
各位女士们、先生们、朋友们，大家下午好！欢迎大家参加今天的陆内投资全球金融峰会。首先，我代表著名的经济学家厉宁先生对本次峰会表示祝贺。他因生理原因不能亲临现场，委托我转达他对会议的召开表示最真挚的祝贺。 同时，因其他公务不能亲自参会的中央财经大学副校长史建平先生，也委托在下向与会的各位专家、学者、企业家们表示欢迎和感谢，并预祝峰会圆满成功。现在，对参加今天会议的各界朋友，尤其是大洋彼岸远道而来的主办方。 美国的贝瑞公司以及中裕通公司、中央财经大学等专家、学者、 以及企业家们表示最热烈的欢迎和最衷心的感谢。随着 5G 时代的到来，我们从互联网时代向物联网时代转变，预示着人类的生活将发生革命性的变化。物联网时代不仅仅是通信技术的迅速提升，而是进入到大数据的整合时代。它使得过去需要几个小时甚至更长的时间整合的东西，可以在几秒或者一秒钟之内实现，大大的提高了生产率。不能说这是对人类文明的一个巨大的贡献。我们这次会议的主题主要是结合美国贝瑞公司、中国中移动公司所研究的成果，实验与中国中央财经大学未来进行了广泛结合，探讨在全球经济一体化下与贸易摩擦下，在贸易的碰撞下的全球的经济走向，交流前沿的实践经验，洞悉另类投资在科技与金融领域的价值，构建全球性的高端人脉与投资机会。这是一场智者的思想碰撞，是一场金融科技结合的滔天盛宴。希望通过此次峰会能够给与会者带来价值有意义的成果。我们知道东西方存在很多的差异，源于历史因素、环境以及思维的方式不尽相同。通过这次论坛，我们会在开放、柔性、互惠互利的基础之上，探讨全球经济一体化下的经济发展，中国提出的一带一路和人类命运共同体的理念已经得到世界大多数国家的认可。这是符合人类进步的主题，也和我们今年的议题相得益彰。科技文明进步到今天，人类必将利用人工智能改变我们的生活方式，使得人类的生产、交易、管理更加便捷有效。无论是我们的生活方式，还是我们的生产方式，一旦插上大数据的翅膀，都将会缩短我们的目标的实现的距离。朋友们，再次感谢各位的支持与参与，祝朋友们身体健康，万事如意。Thank you.
谢谢。